In this video, I will change a poster facial image with a person's face and make a fun birthday greeting. I'll close this off. Load my image of the poster. This is a poster face. This is a photograph of a poster I took down in Tasmania at Cascade Breweries. It's a poster of Fatty Appleton, a colourful brewery worker who was known for his ability to carry two firkin barrels. Now, firkin barrels are a quarter of the size of a full cask of beer, and around about 9 gallons or 41 litres. So we'll change Fatty's face and put another person in there. But first we need to remove the text up the top because I want to put greetings over the top of that. First, if I go to my eyedropper tool and take a sample of the back of the poster. I go to my paintbrush tool and choose a reasonably sized fuzzy brush, move it up a little, and then just paint it over. Now I know it's not blending too well in the background, but the text is going to go over this and it won't appear as bad as what it needs at the moment. Be careful around Fatty's hat and remove all that. Okay, now we go and load our other image as a layer. Open as layers. And I need the other photo, this one here, open as a layer. Now I don't need the full image, so I just take what I need, I go to the rectangular select tool and select around the person's face. Now I'm leaving some of his cap in there because this has a shadow which helps in the final part of placing the image onto Fatty's poster. So we go to edit and we copy that to the clipboard. I don't require that anymore, so I put it in the waste bin. Now I go back to edit and paste. It pastes as a floating selection pasted layer. I make it a layer by clicking on the eye button there or icon. Now I move the poster, the cutout below Fatty's poster. I go to the top and lower the opacity of the poster so I can see the image below. Now I move back down to the lower image, go to my move tool, click the radio button, move the active layer, just move the eyes to match Fatty's eyes. Now the photograph was taken with the same camera, so the sizes match the poster. Now we go back to the top with Fatty is and bring our opacity back to 100%. Now I go to layer and add a layer mask. Full white opacity, add. Now I could have made a alpha channel on the Fatty and just used the eraser and re-raise Fatty's face and reveal the one underneath. But using the layer mask, if you make an error, you can go back and correct your fault. So I change that back to black. Click on my fuzzy brush, and I got a fuzzy brush, and the size is a reasonable size to work with. I need a fuzzy brush so the edges are close behind. They blend nicely with Fatty's face there. Just move it around there and reveal what's underneath. This is the beauty of using a layer mask. If you make an error like I have on the right left hand side there and the right hand side, I can go back and correct that later on. I just paint all that back in there. Now that's revealing the one underneath is what I want. Now I've changed the face of Fatty into this one. Okay, now you can see there I've overgone the edges there, so I change my colour back to white, lower my brush size, and just go and paint back the black in there, which reveals the parts that I overtook. Now I enlarged that a little so I can get nice and close. And can we see what we're up to? There we go, that's much better. You can see how now you can change it back. I noticed we've got a little bit of ear missing there, but I can change my colour back to black and then repair that as well. That's fitting in there reasonably well. I'll go and change my colour back to black and reveal some of the ear, more of the ear. That's it there, a little bit more white, and to fix that little bit there. Okay, so we've got that there. Now we just right click the top layer and we can flatten our image. Reduce the size of my work canvas back to a reasonable size. There we have our change our image on the front of the poster. Now I'm going to add some text. I go to the text tool and I need to change it to a text I know is a much better one for this particular image. Move it up. This capture makes it slow. That one there will do nicely. Aristocrat. I know that the size has got to be reasonably big, so I take it up to around about 120. A little bit there, about 20, that'll do. Just click an area and then type in your text. Increase the text a little bit more. I prefer the old way because I often find it's a bit tricky using the new idea. And what you do, you highlight it and then you can go and change what you want in the roller up the top there. Now I have that, I go to the layers channel, right click my text layer and add an alpha to selection. That selects all the text. It doesn't matter about the colour of the text. Now I go to my blend tool and I choose a gradient that I feel is would match that type of situation. So I come down here and choose the full saturation spectrum and just drag it straight across your text and let go. Now while it's selected, I go to select and I grow that by 2 pixels. That's depending on your image, 2 pixels. Now I change the color back to black by that arrows there, double-ended arrow. Go to edit. Now I stroke my selection. Now it defaults to 6. Now I enlarge the, I grew the selection by 2, so I take it down to 2 by using the tumbler there and click on stroke. Now I go and turn off my selection. Select none. Now I go to my rotation tool and rotate my text a little bit that way and click rotate. Now I go to my move tool and then move the text up so it's out of the way of our character. And just click on the top layer and flatten image. And that's our tutorial finished. I've exchanged the face on the poster with somebody else's face and made a fun happy birthday. Now I don't have any association with Cascade Breweries. I'm not, no financial interest at all. It's just left there as the joke with this Fatty Appleton's poster. So if you visit my channel, you'll find a printout on how to do this in a PDF format.